When you apply for a job, first impressions aren't always everything. You know, with Facebook and sites like LinkedIn, it's easy for employers to make an impression about you before you even walked in the door. Carrie Baker, CEO and founder of Part-Time Pros, is back to talk to us about how to use social media to help you land a job. Hi.
Hi, good to see you.
Great to see you too. We've talked before about how social media can get you fired.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But this is really important, something I haven't thought about. This is a new thing.
Using social media to find your dream job and really putting things out there. 76% of all companies use social media in some way, shape, or form for their recruiting. They look at profiles, they seek out people with certain skills and abilities. So the first piece of advice I give any job seeker using social media to find a job is update your profile. And now is the perfect time, because if you're working, you can look back over the last year and really think about the projects that you've managed, the skills that you've obtained, your level of expertise, and update your profile to really highlight the things that you bring to the table.
So when I think about this, I think about just taking off the negative things, but you can be proactive with your profile on really job seeking.
Yes, yes.
And what's another tip?
Another tip is putting your links on your resume. I'm surprised at how few people do this. And nowadays, you really don't print off resumes. You're looking at them electronically. So I encourage job seekers to have their links on their resume so that a company can click on their LinkedIn profile. They can click on their Facebook or their Twitter and be able to see a little bit about the person behind them. Companies want individuals whose skills are fresh and relevant. And let's just be honest, nowadays social media is the way that people are communicating. And so if you're not even present in social media, there's going to be a red flag there.
I remember back in the day, put special skills. I know Word and a little Excel.
Yeah, so you know Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, Pinterest now is actually something companies are using.
Wow.
So just staying abreast of the new communication trends
is really
important.
And literally put the links in your resume.
Yes.
That's very smart.
Yes.
All right, one
thing. Another one is modify your privacy settings. You know, you want to make sure that only your friends and your family are seeing the things that are truly intimate. I have employees. I want them to be on Facebook and LinkedIn and Twitter, but I don't necessarily want to know what they're doing in their private life. So just modify your private settings with work in mind. You know, people can see your skills. They can see, you know, how you chimed in on a certain discussion, etc. But if there are photos, if there are private conversations
from last year,
or even just your opinion on the debate, you know, there are some things that are better left unsaid, and you just modify your privacy settings so that not everybody can see everything.
And you know, I went into the privacy settings the other day. It's vast now. There's so many different settings.
It
used to be, do you want to be contacted by email or anything, but now it's huge.
Well, you can categorize people. So you can categorize them as a friend, family, colleague, etc.
Right. Okay.
Another thing is following companies. Most fresh and relevant companies are using social media in some way, shape, or form to either promote the services that they do, promote new positions that they have. So following them will help you know where they're headed. If they're hiring, they'll likely have some sort of posting on the positions that they're hiring for. And you may not be a fit for a particular job, but how powerful would it be if you knew a fit and you recommended them to go to that company and apply, and they got the job? All of a sudden, you've got a contact in the company. So just following companies that you have an interest in, if you have an interest in their field or an interest in being part of their team, follow them, because likely it'll give you an idea of the culture and who they're looking
for. It's
such
a different networking time. It used to be networking at parties and things like that and seeking out clubs, but this is such a huge club that you can be a part of. You just have to do it.
The face-to-face networking is invaluable, but this is a way to at least start those introductions, to start those discussions.
Right. So, and there's one more on the list too. What's this one?
Joining groups that pertain to your interests. There's lots of groups out there. There's payroll associations, there's CPA associations, there's marketing associations. If you join groups, they'll have discussions, but they'll also post open positions for various companies. But if you can weigh in as an industry expert, so to speak, then that will get you noticed.
Yeah, the good contacts in that group. Thank you. This is really, really cool. It's something I've actually thought about, but I use it on the other side.
Yeah.
You know, I will seek out if somebody's looking for a job. I'll seek them out and really look. Makes sense. Thank you, Carrie.
Thank you, Casey.
For more on how part-time